You are welcome to another segment of our class. So today we'll be taking a look at volumetric calculations. So we have a series of examples to be going through. So we are going to start by taking a look at example one. So example one goes this way. It says, what will be the mass of 0.015 mole of sodium hydrogen tetrazosulfate 6? So we are asked to calculate the mass, okay, of that given mole in the question. So we bring out the information there. So we have 0.015 mole, and then we are asked to calculate mass of sodium hydrogen tetraoxosulfate 6. So we now calculate the molar mass of this very particular compound. So sodium hydrogen tetraoxosulfate 6 is equal to, so the relative atomic mass of sodium is 23 plus hydrogen is 1, sulfur is 32 plus, we have 4 atoms of oxygen here, times relative atomic mass of oxygen, which gives us 16. So when we sum up everything, you have 23 plus this, which is 24. You have this, so this gives us 120 grams per mole. Are we together? So in this case, what you should do is you use this very particular relation, okay, which says number of mole here is equals to mass of our substance over molar mass of our substance. So which implies that the number of mole we have here, which is 0.015, is equals to our mass is our unknown, which we don't know, divided by the molar mass we calculated here, you put 120. So it implies that our mass is going to be equals to 0.015 times 120, so which is now going to give us 1.8 grams if you do the calculation very well. So we now say that, okay, therefore the mass, okay, of 0.015 mole of sodium hydrogen tetraoxosulfate 6 is 1.8 grams. That's all. So that's how to calculate this very particular problem, solve it out. So it's very simple and straightforward, okay? So just take your time, go through it on and on and on again until you understand it better. So it's very simple. So you just have to go through it on and on. Then example two, which we are going to be taking a look at here. We go ahead by solving example two as this. Before then, let me read the question again. The solution contains 2.65 grams of anhydrous sodium carbonate in 200 ml, which is the same as 100 cm³ of solution. So we are asked to calculate the concentration of the solution in grams per cm³. So very simple. So you can solve this very particular question in two ways. Are we there? So we're going to take a look at the first method. So the first method will explain to us how we are going to solve. So we have, we now say that, okay, our solution, we have 2.65 grams contained in 200 cm³. Okay, so what will be the mass? Let's say x grams in 1000 cm³, which is the standard volume that will lead us to get our mass in 1 cm³, which is in 1000 cm³. So in this case, we have 200x equals to 2.65 times 1000. Remember, X is our concentration in grams per kg. So, this implies that X will be equal to 2.65 times 1000 divided by 200. So, when you punch your calculating device, this cancels this. So, we are left with 2.65 times 10 divided by 2. Okay, so this is going to be 13.25 grams per dm cube. So, by the time you carry out the calculation, then it's written. So, that is for the first step. Okay, then for the second step, we say second method. So, the second method goes this way. So, first of all, what you do is you calculate the molar mass of anhydrous sodium carbonate. So, anhydrous sodium carbonate is written as this, that is the formula. So, you have sodium, which is 2 times 23, plus carbon being 12, plus 3 times 16, which you end up getting 106 grams per mole. Okay, when you calculate the molar mass value, we'll do calculation value, we get 106 grams per mole. Okay. Now, after getting 106 grams per mole, what we do? You go ahead and do okay. N is equal to mass over molar mass. So, we calculate our N. So, when you do that, you have the mass there is 2.65 divided by what? Molar mass, which is 106. But remember, we said N is equal to CV all over 1000, isn't it? So, we already have the volume there. So, if you substitute everything for N, so this implies that we have 2.65 divided by 106 is equal to our concentration T times volume, which is 200 divided by 1000 here. Okay, so when you carry out the math, you have your concentration to be equal to 0.125 moles per dm cube. I will tell that, which is a mass concentration in moles per dm cube here. So, in order to calculate, now use this relation which says that mass, molarity is equal to mass concentration or molar mass. So, you now say that, okay, this implies that your mass concentration, which is in grams per dm cube, is equal to molarity times what? Times molar mass. So, you now say that this is 0.125 times 106, which will be equal to 13.25 grams per dm cube. So, when you carry out calculation, that is exactly what you are going to do. So, any methods you follow, you are going to have the same answer. I hope this helps out. So, in the case you have not subscribed to my YouTube channel for more chemistry video lessons, please do so. And you can as well as recommend the channel to other people. You can share the video for other people. It's completely allowed. Okay? Provided students are going to benefit from it. So, stay tuned for other examples which are going to come your way. So, I hope this helps a lot. Thank you very much. So, have a wonderful day and bye bye.